going to turn a humanitarian catastrophe into a humanitarian apocalypse. And I use that word advisedly because I believe that what we're seeing is history's first televised industrial scale death camp.
אם כך מצביעים על החוק בכללותו בקריאה השלישית לאחר שהוסרו כל ההסתייגויות. הצבעה כעת. 92 בעד, 10 נגד. אני קובע כי הצעת החוק התקבלה בקריאה השלישית ותיכנס.
Good afternoon, everyone. UNRWA plays a critical, important role in delivering humanitarian assistance to civilians that need it in Gaza. That's not the only role they play. They play an important role providing services to Palestinians in the West Bank and throughout the region as well. But they really play an irreplaceable role right now in Gaza, where they are on the front lines getting humanitarian assistance to the people they need it. There's nobody that can replace them right now in the middle of the crisis. So we continue to urge the government of Israel to pause the implementation of this legislation. We urge them not to pass it at all. And we will consider next steps based on what happens in the days ahead.
In Gaza, and indeed the entire occupied Palestinian territory. It would be a catastrophe in what is already an unmitigated disaster. Let's be clear in practical terms what such a measure would mean. Operationally, the legislation would likely deal a terrible blow to the international humanitarian response in Gaza. UNRWA's activities are integral to that response. It's not feasible to isolate one UN agency from the others.
To be frank, it's entirely illegal what the Knesset's done. It's a violation of the UN Charter. It's a violation of the 1946 Convention on the Privileges and Immunities of the UN, which grants the UN all sorts of privileged status. Thirdly, it's a violation of the war, of the rules of belligerent occupation under which Israel is obliged to deliver services. And very lastly, it's a violation of the Genocide Convention, which makes it very clear that these kinds of actions are utterly illegal.